This is my super bargain basement cheap air dam for the front of my cargo boxes. I put these cargo boxes on top of my little RAV4 to be able to carry a bunch of crap. I did them as low profile as physically possible, and it was like I was towing a boat, and it was really, really noisy. So I got some Symbol hardware using galvanized and aluminum, cut some holes in it with a hole enlarger, and then I added a magnet to the screwdriver so that I could put the screw through the recessed hole and I wouldn't drop it off in there, and then I'd be playing with that for the rest of the afternoon. I just clamped it on top, you know, put it together in such a way that I could shoot the screws through it, you know, shoot all the holes through it and make it all fit, because you got to figure I'm winging it. These things are not symmetrical. They have wheels on one side, you know, because they open only to one direction. Anyway, so I put some cardboard on there. I put the cardboard on like an ABS plastic. I think it's ABS or Kydex, one or the other. And cut it with a box cutter. Use a brand new blade. Push as hard as you can. Trace out your line. And I used a wrench to snap it. Okay, I hung this off the edge, put a bunch of weight on it so it couldn't move around, put a heat gun on it, and folded it just like the cardboard, put it up there. And much to my surprise and amazement, it actually fit, and it fit pretty darn good. So I was pretty impressed with that. So now that I've got this lovely piece of plastic that's all form-fitted, I had to install it. So I put a band strap across there, and I did everything with zinc chromate on the aluminum so that it would hold. I used a ribbon kit, that's for installing a windshield, to put across the bottom of it so, you know, once I installed it, it couldn't really move around at all. It can't vibrate on the glass. So then I put these little lights on the sides, you know, so that I could look off to the sides where you cannot see, you know, when you're off-roading, and they were so noisy. I had to put these little gussets on them just to kind of fare them in so that they wouldn't, you know, be grabbing so much wind. And then I put that long light across in the middle there because I wanted to be able to see over weeds or brush. And oh, mother of God, what a bad idea that was. Now I had to think about recessing it or changing the position because it was so noisy. So I went back to my aviation roots, which, you know, I work in aviation, is vortex generators. What if I created some kind of little vortex generators just to break up the air? You know, it breaks up the laminar flow, whatever, just to make it, you know, not be so noisy and so obtrusive. So I folded these little things. I did it with a business card first. So if you want to make something like this, do it with a business card, you know, out of cardboard, light cardboard, and then actually fold them. You know, this is one of my first test ones. It's a little too round. I made some other ones that were better, that were sharper. But anyway, you get the idea. This is how it works. And once I got one of them done, I tape them to a paint stick so that you don't have to touch it, number one. And as soon as you hit it with a spray paint, it's going to fly off onto the floor and get full of dirt. Cleaned it up with a Scotch-Brite to sand it and spray canned it, just rattle canned it. And there they are. Ta-da! And guess what? When I took it out for its first maiden ride at 1 o'clock in the morning, you know, up to, I can't say how fast, it was no longer noisy. So that was the end of that. So now I have my light bar so I can see over bushes. I have my corner lights so I can see around to the sides. And it's not noisy anymore, and it's knocking down all that wind. So ta-da! Do it yourself.